Virtus.Pro versus OG, where VP are taking a commanding victory in game one, game number two. What's in store? We're going to find out, as always, at least for our European games today and yesterday. I am joined by Knoxville, and we're straight in on the draft, man. I was in before there was even a first ban.
That is the first. Normally, like, we miss the first couple of bans on...
That only happened once today. That only happened once today in the earlier series, but I always try and get in before the first pick happens.
Yeah, you have some good promotional videos that need to roll before it starts, and...
It's actually really cool. Like, they're not as long as I thought they would be. Like, as far as ESL One sponsors go, it's very simple. Like, Genting Resort and NVIDIA. Yay!
Yeah.
We have a 2-minute video to play beforehand. And the only sad thing is, though, I'm not seeing enough memes coming out of those videos.
I mean, there's enough memes we're on Twitch chat as it is, though. People just saying, lol.
Pretty sure. It's like all the videos are actually quite normal and appealing to the eye and not that insulting. You know, like you have like some of those videos you watch and your retina just
G2A.
G2A.com. Oh my god,
My favorite is still earn real money.
No, that was funny because Shiva did it.
So I love it. It's great.
That was hilarious.
Okay,
yeah.
So
but then our sponsors, big shout out to NVIDIA for being the sponsors of this tournament, ESL for working it out. Let's get into our draft, man, because we're already into the ban phase, and Virtus.Pro, they're sensing the no-tail Naga, and they banned it out in the first phase.
Yeah, it's been a fallback great strategy for OG, so Virtus.Pro, if they want to keep this going, they want to keep the momentum going, they don't want to play a long Naga game.
I love that mindset, though, for Virtus.Pro. Like, Ramsey's sitting there, he said, like, it's their fallback strategy for OG. Do you want them to then force them back into the same thing, and then VP like, well, we'll do the same thing.
Yeah, so OG had first pick this game, and Virtus.Pro chose Dire. Just a selection priority note.
Ooh.
And first pick Batrider, nothing too unexpected here.
I have a lot of confidence in S4 to keep picking that up in the first phase, and now he's up against an Ogre and a Lifestealer.
Unless they pick DK or Oracle, something like that, then I think Batrider now becomes their like most picked hero patch, and its only loss was that last game.
So does OG go with what they did before? Do they actually have the confidence to run something like a Drow in this lineup, or do you just like just get a good second support hero now, go with the standard, and then take the risk with a second ban phase?
Yeah, I think you just pick Fly his hero now. His hero pool isn't the greatest of his team, and like Jurex is very versatile, Anna's very versatile. I think that you either take the Outworld Devourer now, if you think that you can deal with everything, you know, like any of the harass that comes out from Ogre Magi, or you fall back on a, like, safe Fly hero.
And that should be really nice if you get the OD now, and then Jurex can run his Roaming Mirana. That would make for a very entertaining game, viewer-wise. I don't know if it would be the strongest thing to help beat Virtus.Pro out with, but...
I think we need to see some... Yeah, we need to stop seeing some Batrider. Yeah, Eventual Spirit. Okay, so we have our Fly hero, and then for Virtus.Pro, we have a Lil Roaming hero, and we have a Ramsey's, like, stock standard classic in the Lifestealer. I think if I had to write his signature heroes, it would definitely be one of the three.
So what's his combo hero? Like, when normally Ramsey's has his Lifestealer, you look for transport from the other cores.
No one could play Storm, could play Puck again.
Mm-hmm.
Could even see a Darkseer on the side of Virtus.Pro. It's like one of those situations.
Banned. It got banned.
Oh yeah, sorry, it got banned, yeah.
We triggered the chat.
Oh yeah, what did we say?
We need more lulls.
GTA?
No, need more lulls.
What's the duck? Yeah, I see lots of Toba please. That's actually my favorite, like, indiscreet meme.
I've accepted the Toba. I'll have to make an emote for it. But like, even the emotes on my Twitch channel all start with the prefix Toba now. I have accepted the way I talk and the shit that I get for it. Good. No OD. No worst spirit. No AoE control of the puck, and they do actually remove that Storm Spirit you're talking about.
Yeah, I mean, it just makes sense. Like, we're reaching a stage where both teams need mid, so three of the four heroes are mid heroes that get banned. and Jurex is ravaging Ospreet.
Alright, so VP, how do you want to run it?
I think we see maybe a DK come out here, even without the aura from Drow Ranger.
Talking for OG here?
Yeah, for OG. Okay. It's also nice because it's ranged stun, instant stun, not something that can be disjointed by the Lifestealer, but it is a strength hero, something that the Lifestealer can chunk through later, but does have high armor. Maybe we'll see the Sven. That was something that Adfinim picked against Lifestealer, and it works really well.
I would also flag the other two big ones which are on the field, Juggernaut and Ursa. Have normally been the two big ones picked up against the Lifestealer.
I'm not a huge, huge fan of No-Tails Ursa. It's here. Never know.
Would make for... Yeah, okay. Yeah, no, it'll be fine. It'll be fine. Like, VP don't really have the greatest kiting. That's what I'm thinking about now. Where VP could potentially now go into Disruptor. Pick up, we go back to Solo's classic, and let the Ogre go to the secondary support. Beastmaster. And the primary reason I'm thinking that is because I'm looking at the counter to the Batrider, which they don't have. There's no counter to the Lasso.
Yeah, Nyx is pretty good against Batrider, able to constantly get off the spam of his mana burn and run.
But now with the Beastmaster pickup, you kind of fill your third role. It's been a while since we've seen a four-position Beastmaster, but that is a small option for VP.
Or a four-position Nyx Assassin. I think both are unlikely. I think you're right. I think it's going to be offlane Beast, safe Lifestealer, Lil, Roaming, Ogre. They're missing a no-one hero, which they almost always draft last. Almost all the teams are drafting their mid like as late as possible if they don't get something overpowered, such as the OD or Invoker. Sometimes even Invoker has been deferred to four pick now.
VP are missing burst damage with their hero. Oh, they're still going to go for the budge? Even up against Lifesteal?
Filthy hookers. It's going to be incredible. So Jerix has got his hero. He was really good yesterday.
He really was. But it was in synergy. It was in synergy with the two heroes, which he's probably not going to get this game.
Yeah, Clockwork. Was it Clockwork and DK?
It was Clockwork. DK was one of them. But the things which he really synergized with was False Promise. It was with the Oracle.
Oh, yeah. Oracle,
The Oracle gave the Pudge the sustain on the front lines, which was really good. This Pudge is different. It's kind of like going to be that screwy thing, which potentially could catch out the Beastmaster and force him problems. But the Beastmaster is also going to have Call of the Wild. He'll have a whole bunch of images around creatures around him to maybe tank the hook.
What's also quite nice about this draft from Virtus.Pro is the synergy, like the increased attack speed aura. Really good with Lifestealer, who goes for more of a chunking, like single hit, like a big hit. Do a lot of damage, big hit, do a lot of damage. So wouldn't be surprised to see Mirana, not after the Aghanim's, going for some more physical item, physical DPS items. But yeah, there's like strong group up and death ball type of strats from Virtus.Pro. Not early on, but later on they're going to be able to force objectives very easy. And Pudge is actually very good against that. Like, as they're grouping up or as they're pushing your objective, you're able to isolate one of them in a nice way. Batrider as well.
Invoker. There's the Invoker. So they don't wait until the fifth one to pick up their mid.
Yeah, I think it's kind of needed because otherwise it would get banned. We've already seen so many good bans come out.
Wait. They still ban the Tro?
I mean, we haven't got a No-Tail here.
Yeah, but I can see it.
I mean, what else is No-Tail gonna play? Faceless Void?
That's actually not too bad. I'm still thinking the safety of something like a Juggernaut is the better.
I think the problem with Juggernaut is that they do... Okay, Slark.
Fights can sustain long enough if Voker gets a good start, then I can see this working for OG. If not, Beastmaster could destroy that slot. If he gets like Blink Dagger and Necro 3s and has the Vision on the Slark when he jumps in, which with the Beastmaster, Vision is always a good thing for him because he's always got the Hawks up. Yeah, I'm kind of liking this from VP. I'm liking this draft a lot from VP, and they haven't even picked their fifth. Even if that's a Mirana mid or not. Like, we can assume it's a Mirana mid, and then VP look for better control in the Slark. Well, it's actually like one of the best supports they could pick up now. Against the Slark.
I would definitely say Disruptor if it wasn't banned as the last ban. Yep. It would be perfect. Solo's incredible on the hero.
I wonder why VP picked the Mirana now. As opposed to
oh my god.
Bloodsucker! Yeah.
They've actually played Bloodseeker already. No, OG's played Bloodseeker.
But you don't have anything recorded for Virtus.Pro?
They have played it, but twice actually, and they've won both. But I don't know which games it was when. I would guess actually neither of them are from the elimination mode. They're both from other normal since draft tournaments.
Yeah,
one was from the summit qualifiers against Team Liquid, and one was from Dota Pit against Team Empire. I'm not going to take the Liquid success as massive because Liquid are having an interesting, turbulent period of time. But the, you know, whenever two CIS titans match up against each other, even if it's like Virtus.Pro who are doing really well at the moment and Empire who are not having such a great time, you know, unexpected things happen. And with the Bloodseeker, they won that game in 15 minutes.
15?
Yeah, 15 minutes, 23 seconds.
Holy crap. Okay, that's fast. Well, we'll see if VP like are capable of this, of achieving the same. As off we run, straight mid TPs, Jirax and Solo.
That's also was quite interesting.
Ships in the night. someone's gonna be looking for this because OG keep doing this exact movement. Like there's not even a change. There's not even like a small little tweak to it. No Tell's also smoked up, so he's doing the same maneuver. Solo's smoke wore off a little bit earlier. And that's why No-Tail is... Wait, what? Okay.
It's really good against the Beastmaster. Beastmaster can't get a lot out the lane if the supports are doing a good job zoning it.
They saw No-Tail.
He's fine.
Yeah, he can always just pounce away. He's far enough away from the ball that no one's going to catch him. But now they're going to be questioning...
No one is going to catch him. But yeah, what's interesting is that Solo's playing the Ogre Magi, which is like kind of we normally would expect Lil to, because it's like a roaming, harassing, annoying, pesky little thing. Whereas we do see Lil on the Bloodseeker now, and he's got Iron Talon, ready to jungle, ready to rumble.
Yeah, good luck with that.
And nice counter ward, Anna. They get the counter ward towards the bottom area. They're going to contest the rune, though, so...
That still means the top one should go to S4 unless Ramsey's... Like, he skilled Rage. S4 is trying to have a crack at him. And you go, Rage, he'll get rid of the Napalm. Is S4 going to keep... No. He at least drops Ramsey's down. He'll have to commit a couple of consumables.
And look at the Lifestealer item build. Two sets of Tangos and a Magic Stick holding gold back for Fast Boots. Or maybe... Maybe Quilling Blade, Star Shield. Maybe they were just unsure about how the lane was going to go, exactly what was going to happen.
Mm-hmm. Which is support Bloodseeker. That Anna did this. Okay. That's what Anna did in the games freaking yesterday. And it looks so odd where he commits like his early mana to try and get a Sunstrike on a creepy doesn't kill. I don't know if he's just trying to push the lane out, like if that's his objective too.
And a better block from no one in friends. Virtus.Pro holding the high ground.
S4 is trying to kill Solo off. Solo's attempting the pull, but he's a little bit too late for it. He doesn't get the stack either. He's got five sticky napalm charges. Wow. Okay. That's a kill. Beastmaster drops down inside the Radiant Jungle. To be honest, Tal's looking at S4. He has six. Napalm charges over on Solo.
Yeah, what's really nice, again, if you're a Lifestealer against the Batrider, is your Rage resets the sticky napalm stacks, whereas there's very few other things which are able to just get rid of that, like as just normal spells. But this lane seems a lot better for S4. He just needs to be cognizant of whatever move speed items Ramsey's has, and always try get as much farm as he can without dying, and he'll be like A4 away.
Lil still getting some good experience out of the jungle. making the most of the two camps he's got. Kind of funny, like this. Oh, Jirax. There's a lot of Jirax there. Three of them, in fact. Chasing up after Lil. He doesn't have his level 2, so there's no hook. He's just a pure rot man. Where Solo's also coming over to help out, so they send an illusion up the hill to start with. I deny. It's a good vision for Res 4, so he knows if he can actually contest Lil. And Anthony is doing, or at least leech some experience. And Jirax, okay, they're gonna loop around him. Lil goes straight in for the blood right. Gonna force Batrider back a little bit further.
Fly is just trying to be as annoying as he can, but when you've got the boars going like this, he's got Star Shield. Needs more friends in the area to be able to bring down Pasha. An action top, Jirax.
Yeah, those friends are all on Jirax. He misses the point blank range hook and dies to the Ogre. You'd have to hit it onto Lil and still get some good rot damage in to kill that Bloodseeker.
Yeah. Early on, just running around and people dying a lot. Seems about right. But No-Tail's had a pretty great start so far. Not as many last hits as the Lifestealer, but full wave under the tower. He's going to snag all of these, you would expect.
It's going to be the concern of OG, though. Like, S4, okay, S4's in a world of hurt. He doesn't have enough mana for Firefly. So, Bottle arrives, but it's all a little bit too late. The timing for Solo right behind him, they can just keep ticking him down. The Bloodseeker dies at the same time as Jirax gets a solo kill on the Bloodseeker. Thanks to the Observe Ward on this hillside, must have caught him at the perfect time.
Yeah. Bloodseeker pretty low and always susceptible to getting gangs in the jungle.
Anna again trying to go on to no one. Jirax, this rotation. You give this man an aggressive hero. Oh, no! Oh, no one read it perfectly. He'll screw up his own Starfall though, so he doesn't need anything with that. And that could have been enough to get the kill onto Jirax if it did connect. Jirax just wants to get out of here. I don't think S4's too happy about that. S4 could have given him like a couple of bottle charges. But mid lane, Mirana, Fly initiated him with a haste rune, loses his life, but it's for the cause, it's for the Ana cause.
Yeah, and very importantly that Ana got the kill in that situation. I mean, not important in the sense that like bad things would have happened, but it's just so optimal that he does get it. Jirax suicides. Classic. Once more.
Spends all of his money. I submitted my my proposal for the change on that one. Saying.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. No idea if we'll do anything there, but I guess we'll find out after TI. I mean, after Boston. Whoops! Jirax.
What did Ice Frog say?
Sorry, oh, no, I didn't send it to the frog. I sent it to someone lower than the frog. But still high.
So like Gabe, you just send it straight to Gabe.
Oh yeah, because obviously Gabe is below the frog.
I mean, oh, a little bit of bottle abuse in 2016 happening here in the mid lane. No one getting a quick refill from his friend Solo.
S4's got really good vision here, thanks to the Observe Ward. Lil's coming over. The Observe Ward told him exactly where, so S4 waits behind the tower, and now they move over. Rot, sticky napalms. The hook's able to hit. Quick and efficient damage,
mid.
But Ana trying to stand his ground against no one. Remember, that rotation's going to come in just like before. You get a kill in mid. Jirax rotates down. He's short of the mana for a hook, however. So he cannot get the initiation off until now. Mana is up, and he latches it. He hits no one. No one does have the leap. Tries to get away. The rot's still on him, and the Starfall! With the physical damage, you'll find the kill. There's not enough mana in Ana to get a good Sunstrike off. Even the 3 points might not be enough. Fly rotates up, the Wave of Terror will connect, so a little bit of negative armor to deal with. Solo's okay with that. He's got a lot to spare, so they send the illusion in to try and see, and the Sunstrike right on the money! The boar actually tanked up a little bit more of that. But Ana, still in the neighborhood, still finds the kill.
Yeah, so much action happening everywhere, kill in a half a minute.
Force putting kind his of ass in the face of Jirax, who tried to initiate a Ramses. Ramses is kind of okay with this. again, they gotta stop hitting each other. Firefly to start with. Open wounds works really nicely for Ramses when he's feasting off such a huge pile of fat that is Jirax, and Lil will move in. Bloodright will get the kill, but no! He commits suicide! The rupture, however, it does ensure the kill on the Batrider. So they both can't suicide.
And meanwhile, No-Tail just farming away downtown. He's gonna get a Shadowblade at a pretty decent timing.
I'm wondering if this is one of these games too where he needs to consider going Hand of Midas.
Yeah, that's something that Resolution was always like really good at deciding when he was playing Sark. Like, is this a Midas game? Isn't this a Midas game? Shadowblade early, do I go straight for like a big item, a big DPS item?
It could hit a very sweet spot in the mid game. Like, Anna's, he's on his road to getting his 9-minute Midas. Yeah, S4 is a little bit of trouble. The arrow's gonna hit. It's only a short range one, so the stun doesn't last that long, but it's long enough. Oh no! Oh! Okay, whoops. Tata is now MVP.
So wait, three people have committed suicide so far in this game and one creep? Or yep. Is it two plus one?
I think we're sitting at 3-1 for the three denies and one creep kill.
Yeah. Top tower is under attack. Okay, so 3 of the 10 kills. Classic.
Remember, that doesn't count though.
Yeah.
Doesn't count the scoreboard.
Yeah, sure.
Well, they're finally going to give GRX some levels on this top lane. That's the upside about this Pudge. The fact that once he has Dismember, they do have a lockdown at all times that can hit the Lifestealer.
The hook also does damage. The damage also does, like, his hook also does damage because it's pure damage.
Penetrates the Rage. Smoke maneuver out from VP. Nova was not seeing anybody scout, and Radiant also scanned it. Really nicely done there by OG. This is just the map awareness, and Anna holds back behind the tower.
Very crucial timing for Anna. He's about to get to his Midas. 30 more gold. And he sends out this Forge Spirit to do his work. Boom.
The Hawk scouting. Durex misses a hookup on top lane in the meantime. And S4, yeah, he knows what's going on. Hobbs does more than enough. Durex. That's a Moonlight Shadow. There's no turnaround. They can see Ramsey still just farming up the small camp there, so the Moonlight Shadow is more of an escape than aggression. Like, unless no one's considering initiation on No-Tail, but that's also not going to go anywhere. No way no one can actually kill off No-Tail.
I love the words that come out. Like, there's no way that no one can, you know.
It's a very negative lane. Arrow? Oh, no one attempted it.
Yeah, I don't think that they can't actually dive Slark, I think. It's just the two of them.
With Rupture, if No-Tail's out far enough, it's possible. He Shadow Dances and then TPs. The arrow will connect, cancel the TP, and Slark wants to keep running. They're actually gonna do this with the two of them. The only way that would have worked.
Yeah, I mean, there's no way they can kill him under tower. There's definitely a way they can kill him if he runs into the creep wave and Dark Pact.
Because he might have felt a little bit more safer under the tower. VP would have had to take more damage under the tower. But for now, we go back to the farming. As always, OG giving Fly just that little bit of extra space so they can bring Swap into play. And Jirax and S4 are on the hunt. Wind lays and Tranquil Boots. Jirax needs to hit this hook. No one, pretty visible, and now he runs out, and the Hawk right on the money. Strange Dismember with the Sunstrike. Murana will not be able to leap in time. S4 even threw out the covering Flame Break in case he was going to.
That was so good. That was a great hook. Maximum range, just clips the... grabs it by the tail almost.
And Jirax with his money flying in, he's going to be able to get himself up to what he did previously. It's the Tranquils and Sol Ring build. He goes on his Pudge. So it's never-ending hooks.
And No-Tail's in behind enemy lines, yeah?
And there's no flying vision over there just yet. The Beastmaster's in the neighborhood, but he's only got his balls on the field. What do you think of this one from Lil? Doesn't upgrade his boots, just goes straight into Dagon.
This is interesting. I mean, when I say interesting, I mean, I would probably report someone if they did this in ranked, but...
It's some good burst damage, in a way.
Yeah. Yeah, they do need the burst damage. It's very important to bring down the Slark. Also, you can mostly go on something like the Ventral Spirit, and he has 800 HP and 8 armor. You can bring him down pretty quick.
VP's got this free tower on bottom. No one's TPing down. VP even scanned behind the tower just in case. It's around the 13 minute mark when you expect the tier 1 towers on safe lanes to be lost anyway. The small trade-off is Anna doing damage to the tier 1 in mid, and Notar bringing the creep wave up to the tier 1 on top.
I'm surprised he's not hitting it. It seems pretty obvious right now that no one's coming to defend. At least on this wave, maybe the next wave.
They didn't scout out, or maybe, no, the observer walls are too far away, they didn't scout out the smoke. He's just creep skipping it.
Yep, fair enough.
VP, now it's their turn to beat into a tier 1 mid. Small little rotation coming in from the Ogre. You definitely want to try and fight this one. While they've got that Beastmaster Roar up, they're looking for the good opportunities. Now the hook. Oh, I caught Ramsey. Dragged him up to Jirax. Keep him out of the fight for now until the arrow from no one able to connect onto Jirax. A very quick death of the VS as well as Pudge. Most supports down.
Everyone died so quick there that Ramsey's was able to get top and defend. And there's a little bit more action happening here. Anna getting stunned up, gonna get silenced as well. He's a goner.
I don't know if they just felt confident enough to move forward, but... like, there was D-warding kicking in. Now your lasso, Notal, involved in a fight for the first time in this game. Looking for another opportunity. You can move over to solo, steal off a little bit more. They want to kill off no one. They go for both, and they claim both. S4 and Notal, realizing just how much of the cookie they could bite into.
Yeah, that's like really good awareness. Like if you said like in an abstract sense, we had a team fight, we lost two of our heroes and we lost another one, and then your two remaining heroes that you have go into fight versus three and you make two kills, that's like either really, really good or really bad decision making. In this case, really good decision making.
All they have to do is now just avoid the first part of that. We just lost so many heroes.
Yeah. I mean, they did a lot of good damage at the top lane while that was all happening, but maybe a little bit of inexperience against playing against Bloodseeker in like a top tier competitive sense.
Possible.
Anna was also very unlucky, got silenced as the prerequisite spells to get off a ghost walk, so...
Virtus.Pro was smoked up. Lil's the only one not involved in the smoke, but they're gonna jump into the Roche pit. They got the level 1 Necropulse to help out with the Roshan attack.
Yeah.
Ping's already coming out. That's coming out from Jirax. They didn't have proper vision of the movement there, but with the invis rune of Jirax... Wait, where's the sentries? It's only level 1 Necrobooks.
They don't have any true sight.
Okay, Jirax can walk into the pit. He can walk in. Roshan's already down, however. Ramsey's is very low. 29 HP he'll leave on. The arrows are flying to Notal. He wants to just keep running a little bit further away. But now he's buffing up... Wait, Pasha? Him out in the last moment. Slark is still alive.
If Jirax was there like a little bit earlier and he saw Ramsey's walk out, he would have hooked him and got the kill like every day of the week.
It's the understandable though that you... It's understandable though, you'd expect a sentry ward to be down.
Yeah. He played a bit cautious. It's obviously okay.
And with Echo Saber first up, the opposite style of the build to the previous Slark. We saw the Shadow Blade first. Rotation initiation. God, OG must be, again, paranoid. They're scanning just above them to the north. Because they've lost all their vision from here. The Observer Wards all got dewarded out. The new ones were not there to replace it. VP's vision's actually quite good. I love this little ward. This is multiple times I've seen VP plant this ward near the top rune. And S4, like, that sentry is only just out of range of it. Like, they're actually... they're throwing a sticky napalm up there to look for it. Haste.
Yeah, and despite what a great start we saw from Notel, he's only got Echo Saber, like, nothing else. You know, 16 minutes in.
Offline. He needs to get out of this. He's running too far. He's gonna die to Blood right anyway. Jump in, Notel's low on life, couldn't bring down Lil far enough, and then the Roar, they move on to the Invoker, there's your Dagon. killing off the Slark, and it's just bail, bail, bail from OG.
Bloodseeker build is working out so well. Nice play. And Bloodseeker is not a hero we see very commonly in competitive games. Wing said they had a strat for it at TI, but they never got to show it. No hero.
Said they got to show us the techie strat.
Yeah, that didn't work out that good.
Seems good, bro.
I mean, Bloodseeker was one of like the five heroes that wasn't picked at TI. It was like Visage, Bloodseeker. Who else was there?
Well, Visage is understandable considering he offers almost nothing.
Yeah, I mean, Visage is so bad that even the best, one of the best, probably the best Visage player in the world isn't playing it. And that's Lil.
Yep. They had an opportunity. They actually had a really good opportunity in the early part of the qualifiers. And I'm sitting there going, like, is this the time? Is this the moment? Is this the day? And I was like, this is none of these. The
it was like,
is
I remember
F,
that game.
The
they
above.
Had like Drow. It was like Drow, Mirana, and some of the really good support.
Oh.
And it was clear that Lil needed a hero.
In any other like patch, he would have done it. OG now smoke up. They're trying to find initiation. If you can't take VP head on, how do you try and counter it? Take him one by one. S4 came a little bit too close towards the tower. He's not in range of any vision of VP. And Fly puts an observer ward around the back so they can look for it, but look, VP has cottoned on to what's going on. They're also reaching a better strength point. Level 3 Necropux now over on the Beastmaster. Lil completed up an Aether Lens. So going to increase range and damage. Ramsey's in a very comfortable position, looking like Desolator is going to be his next primary item. And you're going to blink an Aghanim Scepter over on the Mirana. And I'm labeling all these items before we even hit the 19 minute mark. That's probably the scarier thing right now for OG. They're fighting up against an almost like 9,000 net worth advantage going the way of VP. And about 7,500 in the experience.
Yeah, but that's why OG looking for the trades, taking the top tower.
They're losing this trade. They're too quick.
They'll get the tower eventually, but they're going to take so much damage on their tier 3s, maybe lose the whole tier 3. Hook going to miss on Ramses. Tower's about to fall.
With the level 3 Necrobox, they could. S4 so low on life. Anna! Lil knew it. Lil played it perfectly. He is now going to get lassoed into the base, however, so the fountain will kill him off. Meliorex has already gone down. No one. They're going to have that Aegis trigger out. The Necrobox are bit by bit taking out the Range Drax. OG knows Range Drax don't mean Jack. They need to find some kills. Oh, they lose this game right now. Ogre Magi, their primary target with a roar, pushing it back. Anna has to hide inside the invis. Do they have enough? No, Xerox can't do enough work. And Nota just has to stand still. He's got the Shadow Amulet. It's the only thing that's keeping him alive. Necrobox are on cooldown. The sentry wall is too high up in the lane. Now Notel will move. But Virtus.pro, triple kills going the way. I think it was the lifesteal who got it out of all of that. Yeah, it was. So much money, so much experience, and the racks before 20 minutes.
Yeah, once again, if you look at the net worth charts, four heroes for pro in the top four. And then a big gap, and as you would expect, it's solo right at the bottom. But that's doing what he does. And it's working out. Great start here. I think Lil...
Hang on.
I was just saying, Lil continues to amaze. Real innovator here. The Bloodseeker, Dagon, Blood Rites go wild. Providing a lot of utility to the fight.
I kind of love the fact that Solo, we talk about him so many times being so low on the net worth, but also being such an effective, like, player. Even with like low net worth. Okay, Notel, this has to work for you in some way. Okay, that's heavy damage. No Sunstrike. He's got the kill. Dodges the arrow. Tries to stay inside. The Shadow Dent and TP out. Oh no! It wore off! Before it! So the Yule Scepter cancels the TP. Ah, balls.
It's a disaster. Yeah, VP just gonna group up now. I think they might take the... Yeah, they're signaling to go towards the top two. They want to take that out. Remember last game, kind of the thorn in their side was the top tier two, how long it took for them to eventually bring it down. And no one beat an absolute beast. Ramsey's also 6-0 and 5. Signature performance and a signature hero.
This is just
and it just seems to me like Fly hasn't really got stuff done this game as a support compared to the supports of Virtus.Pro.
A long time to pick like his VS as well. Is this really the right hero? And they picked it up before they really saw much more of VP. It didn't counter anything VP had.
Maybe also potentially a block pick because it's a strong synergy. Yeah. You have Venge, Mirana, Ogre Magi, Beast, like strong auras and stuff.
True. Bounces out, no tell. Trying to get involved in this, but already he's lost his Invoker. But Invoker, there's no way to come back. It's 5x on cooldown. Nice hook from T-Rex, dragging Ogre in deep, and they lasso the Beastmaster, trying to make so he can't actually get his roar off. But it doesn't matter. The Bloodseeker is all over him. You lock down the Lifestealer, but it won't matter. Bloodseeker runs over, and with the help, wait, is someone going to finish the job? One more swipe from Ramsey. That'll do it. GG, Virtus.Pro. Well, you thought of the underdogs, VP, the team that came through the qualifier, OG, the team that gets directly invited, but VP, they're wrecking. They are wrecking OG.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is that while OG might have got the direct invites, I think even despite this result as it's gone so far, I think that teams would